Hello, smart home enthusiasts. Today, we're taking our patio to the next level by making our outdoor outlet smart and improving the way we interact with our outdoor space. We are installing the Aqara T2 Dual Relay module for a seamless automation. Let's get at it. We are taking this Aqara T2 Dual Relay module and wiring it to our existing outdoor outlet behind this waterproof box and making it smart. I currently have this extension cord that connects inside this waterproof box with a splitter to power on the fountain lights and the fountain pump. And it also will have an extension cord that runs over to my patio umbrella to turn on my LED lights.
There's not much to unboxing this really. It's just the device inside here itself. It does have a wire so that you can use it for a wet mode, terminate it in wet mode. The device looks like this. It's got this little bracket on it that'll hold it in place here. It's got the little antenna that goes with it. And then it's got this manual, which really the only thing you want to do out of the manual is turn to the page where you can get this code. And you'll scan that code and it brings you to the Aqara manual online where it has lots of examples of how to wire it for various different configurations.
That's it for the unboxing. Now let's get hands-on and I'll walk you through the installation process. First, ensure your outdoor outlet is turned off for safety. Turn off the breaker at the breaker panel and test to make sure there is no power at the outlet. If you're not comfortable working with AC home electricity, please consult a professional.
I think the hardest part of this install is going to be trying to figure out how to get this box inside that outlet box and get all those wires tucked back in there. I think it'll fit, but I think it's going to be really tight. For sure not going to be able to put that on there. I think I might have to like cut these down in the back, or at least one of these somehow, like trim that down a little bit to get that box to fit flush against that back wall. Okay, so here's what I ended up doing. Going off, take my multi-use cutoff tool, Ryobi cutoff tool, and just kind of cut that straight down and cut it at an angle and got it pretty darn flush right there. So now that gives me enough room to get this box in there nice and flush in the back like that, and now it gives it plenty of room for this to connect in there. We're going to be using this in wet contact mode, and since we're going to be doing that, the instructions say to use this red jumper wire to jump the L in to the L out. So that's the first thing we're going to do here. Okay, feel like I got that in there pretty good. I got my four extra wires that we're gonna need, so we're going to wire the blacks to the black and the whites to the white, so I have the line in and the neutral. Okay, so here's how we have it wired up. We got two of those white wires connected to the neutral here, one of the black wires coming in, and one of the black wires for the load going back out from the line in. Okay, so we are going to put one of the neutral wires into the neutral, one of the line in wires then into the line, and then this will go line out to the load of the switch. So last thing we have to do is wire this to the switch. So this goes to the green screw for the ground. This is the neutral, which goes to the silver screw. So the white wire goes to the silver screw, and the black load wire goes to the brass screw. Okay, last step is to try and figure out how to get all of these wires and these two boxes back in this little tiny outlet box here. Okay, I didn't trip. That's a good sign.
Okay, it's got the power turned back on. So, I wanted to double check everything. It looks like it's good.
And the next step is just to button this all back up. Okay. That was a major pain in the butt. I got it all wired back up again. So now we have the Aqara switch working and behind here, and it is functioning right. So now I have my one extension cord coming in to a three-way adapter, and then have all three of my electrical cords plugged in. One for the light, one for the pump, and then the other one goes over and connects to our umbrella lights.
Now with the physical installation done, it's time to bring this to life. Open your Aqara app and hit the plus icon to add a new accessory. Select the switch and plug, and select the dual relay module T2. Select your existing Zigbee 3.0 hub to bind it to. In my case, I have the M2 hub. Press and hold the button for 5 seconds on the T2 module, and once the device is discovered, you can rename it. Select which location you want it in, and in my case, it's outside. Select a card to display on the Aqara screen and rename it if you'd like. Select the three dots in the upper right-hand corner. Select Device Settings. I like to remember the last state if the power goes out. And since there is no switch, change the switch type to disabled. And make sure the device mode is set to wet contact. And now let's test it out by pressing the button.
And just like that, we have it working. So the light's working, the pump is working, and we have the umbrella working over here. So looks like it's working the way we want. So now we have it set up to work in Aqara. All we have to do is add it to the Apple Home so that we can add it to some automations and some scenes.
Since we added this to Aqara already, it will automatically show up in the default room. In my case, I renamed the default room to Living Room, so we can go to the Living Room and scroll to the bottom and locate the new device. Let's rename it in Apple Home to Backyard Outlet and put it in the correct location, which is outside for my setup. Next, let's add it to the goodnight scene so it automatically shuts off when I set the goodnight scene. Next, let's add it to an automation that runs at sunset to set the sundown scene. And there you have it. We've made our back patio smarter. Thanks for watching, and if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe for more smart home tips and tricks. See you in the next one, and have a blessed day.